Hey folks, today I'm interested in asking a pretty simple question, and that is, we've got two speech synth solutions on the TI-99, and both of them have a reasonably large library of supporting games. So my question is, who does it better? On the one hand, we've got the TI Speech Synthesizer, of course, which dates all the way back to the early days of the TI-99 4. And on the other hand, we've got the Milton Bradley MBX, which dates from the final hours of the TI-99/4A as a TI product. Given that timeline, the MBX bringing speech synth to the TI-99 is a bit odd. It was already arguably the platform's most notable feature, and it was widely used in the game library. So why does the TI-99 need this thing? To do a thing it already does, pretty famously. As to that, the MBX is ultimately a Milton Bradley gaming console that mutated into a TI-99 peripheral, so its feature set was never going to make much sense. Its features are what they are, and regardless, the decision to hitch a ride on the TI-99 worked out interestingly, so I figure we might as well enjoy them for what they are. I mean, on the bright side, more solutions means more options and more variety, and it lets us ask, who does it better? We got plenty enough games that use each device, plenty of MBX, and plenty of TI speech synth titles. And we've even got several games in the MBX library that will use either MBX or TI synth, depending on which is available. Which means we can compare head to head how the same sample sounded, encoded for use by MBX, and encoded for use by TI speech synthesizer. With the TI Speech Synthesizer using a TI TMS5220 synth chip, and the MBX using a General Instrument SP1000 synth and voice recognition chip. And this means we can also find cases where completely different source samples were used for each device, and so you get a very different sound.
Beam up initiated.
Beam up initiated.
Aside from the different synth chip in each of these solutions, there's also a functional difference in that the MBX synth is always going to be coming out of the MBX speaker. That could be a plus or a minus, since if your screen doesn't have a speaker, it gives you a speech audio right from the MBX itself. But if you do already have an audio output for your TI-99, then using a separate output for speech, which offers really limited volume control, might be more of an annoyance than a feature. For the moment, though, the major implication of all this is just going to be that the TI-99 synth is going to be captured directly from an AV jack, while MBX synth is going to be captured from a microphone next to a speaker. Anyway, let's compare. Now, this is a real favorite, popular with 99ers whether or not they've ever owned or used an MBX, since it is feature complete even without one. But obviously, it'll use MBX synth if it is available, as that's true for all MBX titles. Here, the line you'll hear the most sounds like this on the MBX.
I'll get you, Bigfoot.
But it sounds like this on the TI Speech Synthesizer.
I'll get you, Bigfoot.
So, the MBX sounds a little lower and less nasal to me, but another factor that makes the MBX synth better is that the TI synth can be interrupted and cut off by gameplay events, where that just doesn't happen on the MBX. So, dying when low on the screen sounds like this on TI synth. But it sounds like this with MBX synth. Since the MBX is able to continue playing the sample even while the game is resetting, it's been given a job, and damn it, it's going to finish it, no matter what that TI-99 has gone off and done. So, in the light of that, the winner for me, clearly, MBX. Sewer Mania is a classic of TI-99 voice synth, with its voices bringing a lot of character to the game. And we do get that same kind of character in both cases here, with the TI-99 giving us this,
Dave, find the bomb. We'll carry force.
And the MBX giving us this.
Dave, find the bomb. We'll carry force.
I will say there's some clarity benefit to having the synth coming from a completely different audio source. Sewer Mania uses tone and noise effects at the same time as voice synth pretty constantly.
Dave,
And I find the effect of this mix of synth and PSG effects from the TI-99 itself is, well, a little less clear than the MBX alternative, which is an independent synth sound source producing the speech at the same time as the TI-99 produces PSG audio. Still, in both cases, the synth is pretty great. So, the winner for me is the MBX in this case, by a hair. And here's another classic for entertaining TI-99 speech synth. And this is the exception to the cases I've looked at so far. Here's the game's opening line via TI synth.
Where to fly?
And via MBX synth.
Where to fly?
The TI synth just seems a little more fluid.
Where to fly?
And here's the hilarious sound of the fly dying on its last life via MBX synth.
No! Oh, yes!
And then via TI synth.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes!
So I think for me, the TI synth is just funnier and more animated.
Yes!
While the oh no of the MBX voice sounds actually a lot like Dave from Sewer Mania. Which is okay, but not as great as the TI synth. So, winner for me here, TI. Space Bandits is one of the less well-known MBX titles, but it is an interesting design worth looking at. And anyway, the voices we get in its TI voice synth and MBX voice synth are very different indeed, making it worth looking at that comparison. From the TI synth, we get this voice.
Nice shooting, Captain.
And then from the MBX synth, we get this voice.
Nice shooting, Captain.
So, this is a bit subjective, but I much prefer the TI voice here. Makes me feel like George Takei's Sulu is saying, "Nice shooting, Captain," from the Enterprise Bridge. Well, the MBX voice synth is just too high and nasal.
Beam up initiated.
The one point in favor of the MBX is that, as with Sewer Mania, the PSG effects don't walk all over the voice synth quite as much, with the synth playing via the MBX. But aside from that benefit, I'm giving this one to the TI. Meteor Belt's another MBX game that doesn't get a lot of attention. It's a two-player game, and playing against the computer is an option. But the opportunity to play with two MBX joysticks, if you have two, is its unique feature. Just not one almost anyone ever has used, since additional MBX joysticks were never sold. So the only way to have two MBX joysticks is to have two MBXs for no reason? Anyway, in this game there's not a whole lot of difference between the two voice synth voices. The MBX synth sounds like this.
Last blue ship.
While the TI synth sounds like this.
Last blue ship.
And in light of that, I'd say this one's a tie. The winner here is whoever owns two MBX joysticks for some reason.
No!
Oh, yes!
So, there are five titles in Milton Bradley's Arcade Plus series that can play their synth via either the MBX or the TI speech synthesizer. And out of those, I found the MBX synth to be better in two cases, and as well, the TI synth to be better in two cases. With one toss-up that probably nobody cared about, in the form of Meteor Belt. But I think it's worth pointing out that in the two cases where TI wins here for me, it wins because the samples used were just better samples. If the same samples had been used to create the MBX synth, I'm sure it would have been just as good. And on the other hand, and conversely, in the two cases where the MBX wins, it wins due to technical instead of artistic factors. Playing the synth on a completely different computer means it isn't interrupted as often by program processes, and PSG and synth audio are clearer when coming from that different source. So there is some justification for playing your TI-99 synth from an external device in the end. Not much, but some. And the MBX competes just fine with the speech synthesizer when they're competing on even terms, and playing LPC speech generated from the same source. Anyway, this has been a fun little experiment. Thanks for watching, folks, as always. Have a good one. This is Pixel Pedant signing off.